talk of getting old. It's getting me down, my love, like a cat in a bag waiting to drown. This time I'm coming down, but I know she lay down on your side. Now the drugs don't work, they just make you worse. But I know I'll see your face again, 'cause baby, I'm coming too, just like you said. If you leave my life, I'm better off dead. But I know I'm on a losing streak as I pass down my old street. And if you want a show, then just let me know and I'll sing in your ear again. 'Cause baby, ooh, if heaven calls, I'm coming too. But if you want a show, then just let me know and I'll sing in your ears again.
Shit. Fucked it up.
Space and time.
keep our love alive. We have existence, but it's all we share. There is no space and time to keep our love alive.
Few more beers, shouldn't we? I think it'd be good, like pissed.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Bit pissed, bit more kind of fucking loose.
Yeah.
Right.
Lots of skunk smoke.
Let's go. I'm not gonna get into this. There's nothing about that. There's nothing you can. For this to make sense, it's difficult for me. I've just got to start your story.
I feel like.
Feels very exciting to be in the Verve at the moment. With no philosophy, I just think it's my ambition. Again, you become better. You just got to watch. You've got to be clever. You've got to watch about yourself. You need to do to make a great amount. It's not as good as the first two, but we put the prices down a little bit. I reckon we might get a few sales. I just want the music to break in any of the loose people. Verve is a sort of product. There's no words to describe how I'm going to feel on that first concert. Let's Pompeii, Krakatoa. Something of volcanic seismic proportions in my mind. Do you know what I mean? I'm gonna be buzzing. I'm gonna be fucking. One of the moments in life this next few months when everyone's gonna have to get prepared to hold on, to fasten onto the fucking roller coaster. Because we're at the very, we're just going up to the top now, ready to let it go, let the spring uncoil, get shot off into the universe, you know what I mean? Rather than sitting back on our asses and thinking, yeah, we've got a packed house, everyone loves us now, it's about, right, we've got you here, come on, let's fucking have it, you know what I mean? Verve come a long way. Things needed to happen was to get to this point where the energy levels up and the hungers and the fire is burning as strong as it ever has been. That you can only make and create when the fire is burning.
know what I mean? And it's a furnace. We make the music, and what comes with that music comes an attitude and the self-belief that this band can go all the fucking way and stay there. So we've only just started.
I'm
this talk of getting old. It's getting me down, my love, like a cat in a bag waiting to drown. This time I'm coming down, and I hope you're thinking of me as you lay down on your side. Now the trucks don't work, they just make you worse. But I know I'll see your face again. Now the trucks don't work, they just make you worse. But I know I'll see your face again. But I know I pass down my old street. And if you want a show, then just let me know and I'll sing in your ear again. Now the trucks don't work, they just make you worse. But I know I'll see you better.
Success can be a daunting thing, but it can also be an inspiring thing to take it even further.
We've always known from day one where this band's going, like, and now it's finally come. Still say, so, you know, what does it feel like to have your record at, you know, number one or number two or whatever? And it's like, it's just the same, you know what I mean? It is though, isn't it?
I heard The Drugs Don't Work for the first time on the radio and I thought, I wrote that, The Drugs Don't Work. I wrote that. You know what I mean? What's all that about? And how do people see that? it's a lot of, it's many different colours. You see the band write in different ways, and the band have, you know, strengths in a lot of different areas of music and ways of making it. And when Nick's in the room and we're all together, you know, that's a whole new dimension.
And that's our job when Richard writes a song, is to make his songs, like, step up, you know what I mean? If we do that, then that's the key, you know?
I know my lyrics are heavy. I know they're uplifting, and, you know, there's a track called Lucky Man, and the old my, my bit, there's a section where it says, oh, my, my. I know how good I was feeling when I sang that, and I know how good I wanted it to feel, and I know that it all collided, and just someone singing, oh, my, my. I mean, how many people have sung that word? Those words. It's just the way it is, it came out and the way it's sung. So, you know, some words might mean nothing, but it's the way they're sung, it's the way they come out, it's the way they're put across.
Something in my liberty. something in my liberty. It's just a genuine something in my liberty.
seen the crowd out before looking for tickets. It's crazy.
You know, New York City has the best of everything. That doesn't mean you shouldn't play it safe. Please, fucking seatbelt.
Thank you.
America's mad as hell. English people lose their heads when they come over here. That's why I've lost my head, you know. My head's in bits now doing this little interview. But I'm enjoying it. We've all got on the bus. We've all gone bonkers. But we're all here laughing still. That's all that matters. Here to fight another day.
Tell me what you've seen. Was it a dream? Was I in it? Life seems so obscene until it's over. Who knows? All I want is someone who can fill the hole in the life I know. In between life and death, when there's nothing left, do you want to know? You come in on your own and you leave on your own. Forget the lovers you've known and your friends on the road. Tell me if it's true that I need you. You are changing. I've seen this road before down on this floor. It is hell.
I absolutely adore Richard, and I think he's a god, and actually I think that I follow his religion totally. He's very spiritual.
People are coming from all over because it's like nothing else out there today.
And I was right there in the speakers. It blew my mind.
Nick is the best guitarist on the face of the earth.
He's a being. He is real. He's genuine.
Yeah. I love Richard too, and he doesn't love me at all.
There's one thing, I just hope Cy Jones freaks out. I'm waiting for him to burn.
There is definitely some crazy people who want to get in your head, but they're in it for the music, hopefully, anyway, you know what I mean? That's why I'm here.
I've been here since one, and I haven't eaten, and I'm so thankful that I met.
I'm hoping that Richard will sign for me if I can get him.
I gave him a box with the angel Lucifer on it, and it had, like, fortune-telling things in it, and a key that I wore around my neck when the Verve broke up until the Verve got back together.
When you talk to him about our first album, it's like, you think that had some sort of life-changing experience, you know what I mean? It's like some sort of Bible or something, which can be a bit frightening.
Dragging me down.
Did She's a Superstar, and I was right there in the speakers. It blew my mind.
I didn't even know.
You see it last night?
Last night. I have a show, my eyes were closed because, I don't know.
The bass like rips right through you. Exactly. So loud.
I've had it like every time the Verve play, I have to like get some money.
You guys on the
cold. You know, it's got the groove that you need.
Wayne Griggs gonna tear it up tonight.
Good people can relate to at least. They say things that too many people are scared to say, you know? And they're like,
my favorite
honest.
Velvet Morning.
It's like you can't put them in a category. You know how there's like the alternative.
Is that the first time you blew out? They blew out the PA or on the trip on the tour?
Studying law in CLA.
Not in a category. It's in a category. All the time.
I just got out
the bus about 2 weeks ago in Boston. These guys are fucking groovy. That's all I can fucking say.
I really want to see the Verve right now, and it's not possible because I'm 15.
Too much good music you guys have made.
I'm going to off myself.
Thank you for touring.
The Verve Rats.
Thank you for letting us enjoy the music live.
Saw New York, saw Boston, seeing Chicago, in fucking Detroit with no tickets, come on!
That will break your back!
Yeah. I hope you know that Detroit is in the top. It is the top. When we're out, we've played this place before and it has been so fucking bright.
we've gone into this side of music, we've gone into that, and I think that's the exciting thing about the band doing well now, is that's all I've ever really wanted, because I like extreme music, and you know, I think once we've got people listening, we're going to take them on an adventure, like all the great bands should, once they get an audience, not give them second-rate shit, you know, just because they've got limousines now and they've lost it, lost the hunger. When I lose the hunger, that's the day I'll never do it again.
I'm a Verve supporter.
I don't know what Verve is.
All roads would appear to be leading to Wigan tonight. 8:30 right here on your radio live.
Verve fever is hitting Wigan. 33,000 fans are expected for tonight's sellout homecoming gig.
Don't forget, tonight right here, 8:30 is where you need to be. If you're not going to the Hayhorn, you managed to get tickets within an hour of them being on sale. They were sold out.
This is a song called Sonnet.
My friend and me.
It's a song called Velvet Morning.
Twisting out my dead bed alive, all my feelings.
This is a song for the people. This is modern day blues song. This is Bittersweet Symphony.